Hi, great. Good day. I hope na kahit mainit ang panahon ay you are in a good condition. Ayan, inom ng tubig para hindi ma-dehydrate. Okay, so let's start our class for today. Ayan, so we are now in a fourth grading period, grade 2. And for our lesson, let's us and we have an understanding geometric ideas. So, sige, pag-usapan natin itong mga geometric ideas na ito. Okay, first. So, let's go for lines and angles. So, let's go for the lines and angles before we go furthermore to our lesson. Okay, first. So, we have a point. Okay, this is a point. Nakikita nyo maliit na yan na color black. This is the point. So, a point indicates an exact position in a place. So when we see a point, it will give exact direction or exact position in one place. Ayan. So, okay. Next, we have line. So a line is a set of points. Sabi, set of points, ibig sabihin pinagsama-samang points in a straight path extending in opposite direction. So, unending. Pag sinabing line, unending. Walang katapusan. Okay. So, makikita nyo, di ba, mayroong arrow sa magkabilang dulo. So, it means this is the line at hindi ito natatapos. Pwede yung humaba both side. No? Unending siya both side. So, this is what we called line. Next, we have a line segment. Okay. A line segment is a set of points in a straight path with two endpoints. So, ito naman, ending to. So, natatapos to. So, it will give the exact point from the start to beginning. So, kanina, an ending, that is a line. Pero kapag nalagyan na siya ng mga exact points, yung two endpoints, we called it line segment. Okay. So, this is the line segment. Ha? Pag may dalawa kayong tuldok na nakita sa may kabilang dulo, that is line segment. Okay. This one is we called ray. So, a ray is a set of points drawn starting from the specific or distinct point and extending indefinitely in one direction. So, makikita natin yung kanina, yung dalawang, kapag may dalawang point sa dulo, that is a line segment. Ito naman, makikita kayo ng point sa isang dulo, tapos may arrow kung saan nakaturo, di ba? It means that is an ending. So, walang katapusan. Pero, nagbibigay siya ng exact position or yung starting point. Then, you are go to direction and ending. That is we called ray. So this is a ray. Okay, wag malilito. Pag isang line na merong arrow sa magkabila, dulo, we called it line. Pero kapag may tuldok sa dalawang dulo, we called it line segment. Pero pag isa lang ang tuldok, tapos nakaturo in a opposite direction na indefinitely or unending, we called it ray. Okay. Now, if we see these two lines or two line segment na magkatapat, we called it parallel lines. Once again, can you say it? Parallel lines. Okay, very good. Medyo nakakabulol lang, pero we called it parallel lines. Ibig sabihin, yung magkatapat na arrow, they never intersect or they never meet each other. We called it parallel lines. So parallel lines are straight lines that never meet each other no matter how long we extend. Kahit napahabain pa natin tong mga lines na to, hindi sila mag-meet. So we called it parallel lines. Okay, next. Ito naman. Nag-meet na sila. Okay, nag-meet sila sa one exact point or one common point. We called it intersecting lines. So when two or more lines cross each other in a plane, Okay. They are called intersecting lines. So these are the intersecting lines. The intersecting lines share a common point. You know, may share sila sa common point, which exists on all intersecting lines. And it's called the point of intersection. In this example natin, ayun yung nasa gitna, yun yung kanilang point of intersection. Where there, na doon sila nag-meet doon sa point na yon. Ayan. Okay. So, meron pang isang klase ng intersecting lines, pero iba yung tawag sa kanya. Ito, we called it perpendicular lines. Okay, ano naman itong perpendicular lines? Okay, perpendicular lines are the two distinct lines that intersect at each other at 90 degree. Paano natin malalaman na 90 degree? Okay, we will know that this is perpendicular line kapag nakabuo tayo ng square. Ayan, katulad nito. Ayan. Na hindi natin magagawa sa intersecting lines. When we create a square in the middle, that is 90 degree. Ayan. So, straight siya pa, horizontal at saka vertical. Ayan, we called it perpendicular lines. Hindi siya naka-diagonal. Ayan, one thing na meron sa perpendicular lines, their lines is not diagonal. You will see the lines are straight horizontally and vertically. Ayan. So, ang dali, di ba? Okay. Now, angles. Punta tayo sa angles. Okay. Now, we have acute angle. So, ano naman itong acute angle na to? Actually, angles are created by two rays. Ayan. So, we have acute angle. So, this acute angle is an angle that measure less than 90 degree. Okay, mamaya makikita nyo kung kailan magiging 90 degree. Okay, yung ating angle. Okay, this is an example of an acute angle. So, sa acute angle, may tinatawag tayong vertex. Ano yung vertex? Ito yung tip of the ray. Ito yun. Ayan. Ito yung vertex. Ayan. So, this is a vertex. So, these are the two ray. And it is measured less than 90 degrees. Ito yung vertex niya. So, less than 90 degrees siya. So, that's what we call acute angle. Okay, parang ganito. Yan, pag nakakita kayo ng ganyan, that is acute angle. Okay. Next, we have a right angle. Okay, a right angle is an angle that measure 90 or exactly 90 degree. If you see kanina dun sa perpendicular lines natin, no, nabanggit yung 90 degrees. So, meron siyang angle na 90 degrees. Hindi pwedeng maging 91, hindi pwedeng maging 89. It is exactly 90 degrees. Ayan. So, tingnan nyo yung ray, vertically straight. Tapos, yung ray na horizontally straight. So, this is a 90-degree measure. So, this is what? Right angle. Ayun. At isa pa, nakabuo doon ng square doon sa may corners niya, doon sa may vertex niya. Okay. Kung kanina, pag ganito, ay acute angle, ngayon, paano naman ang right angle? Right angle, ganyan. Ayan. Parang letter L. Pag nakakita kayo ng two rays na like it's letter L, it is right angle. Okay? Right angle yan ha. Next, obtuse angle. So, ano naman yung obtuse angle? Obtuse angle is more than 90 degree, pag lumagpas na siya sa 90 degree, but less than 180 degree. Dapat hindi aabot sa 180 degree. So, that is obtuse angle. So, paano naman ang obtuse angle? Ang obtuse angle ay, yan. So, acute, right angle, and obtuse angle. Okay, that is obtuse angle. Okay, so more than 90 degree, ibig sabihin, lumagpas na siya sa 90 degree. Pero, hindi dapat siya makapunta sa 180 degree. So, that is obtuse angle. And teacher, paano kapag umabot ng 180 degree? That's what we called the straight angle. Ayan, ganito. Pag nakaganyan, straight angle yan. And also called as flat angle. So, a flat angle is measured exactly 180 degree. Ayan. So, okay, ah. Okay, we will know all the lines and angles that we have. Now, you know, kids,